with reach to set.
I dare say.
find me too highly spiced, if you like. And I suppose I am highly spiced.
Not for my taste.
No, but I am for theirs. But I shall show the world that I can be as mild as he. If it's insipidity thereafter, they shall have it. I'll meet this fellow on his own ground and beat him on it.
You shall, and I will help you.
You will? Oh, Jane, there's a good deal of good in you after all.
So go to him and say to him with compliment I rather go.
Sing day to you, good day to you, and that's what I shall say.
Your style is not so sacred, but your cut is too canonical.
Sing bar to you, bar to you, and that's what I shall say.
I was the beau ideal of the mob, but the young aesthetical Duke, and my inspiration was regarded as heretical until you cut me out with your placidity.
Sing boo to you, poo poo to you, and that's what I shall say. Sing boo to you, poo poo to you, and that's what I shall say.
Sing hey,
sing good day.
Boom! Boom! to precedent, and single I shall live, and I shall have to be contented with the heartfelt sympathy.
He will have to be contented with the heartfelt sympathy. In that case of precedent, and single I shall live, and he will have to be contented with the heartfelt sympathy. So far as to say I would do it, but I must not allow myself to be unmanned. Oh, consent at once, it's useless. Consent at once, or may a nephew's curse...
Oh, are you absolute resolved?
Absolutely.
Well, nothing, Jim.
Nothing, I am adamant.
Very good, then I yield.
You what?
I yield.
You swear it?
I do, cheerfully. I have long wished for a reasonable pretext for making such a change as you suggest. It has come at last. I do it on compulsion.
Victory! I triumph! When I go out of doors, of demoiselles and scores, or sign of union clearly burning with polony as before, as I with cultured taste, distinguished gems from paste, and hated and diddle will represent diddle if I pronounce it chaste. A most intentional man, a silver polite young man, and not a poetical, super aesthetical, out of the way young man.
See me if you can. An everyday young man, a common respect with a stick in the pipe and a half red black and tan, who thinks of all and pops, of one that Monday pops, who's fond of his dinner and doesn't get dinner on what the beer and jobs.
A commonplace young man, a matter of fact young man, a steady and sunny, jolly by God, an everyday young man, a Japanese young man, a blue and white young man, Francesca de Rimini, Mimini, Pimini, shouldn't say quite young man,
a Chancellor Lane young man, a Somerset House young man, a very delectable, highly respectable, threepenny bush young man,
a pallid and thin young man, a haggard and lank young man, a greenery gallery, grooving and gallery, foot in the grave young man,
a shrill and cross young man, a Howell and James young man, a pushing and particle, what's next out of the Waterloo House young man,
could see me if you can, a crunch of a crack young man, an hour aesthetic, a lot of poetic, a out of a day young man, could see me if you can. I committed my last act of ill nature, and henceforth I'm a character. I'm a changed man. Hitherto I've been moody, fitful, uncertain in temper, and selfish in disposition.
You have indeed.
Oh, but all that's changed. I've reformed. I've modelled myself upon Mr. Grosvenor. Henceforth, I'm mildly cheerful. My conversation will blend amusement with instruction. I shall still be aesthetic, but my aestheticism will be of a most passable kind.
Oh, Rachel, it's always true.
Of course it is. Observe how amiable I am.
Dreadful, how long will this last?
Oh, with reasonable stops for rest and refreshment, as long as I do.
Oh, Reginald, I cannot express the joy I feel at this change. It will no longer be out of duty to love you, but a pleasure, a rapture, an ecstasy.
My darling.
I do it on compulsion.
This is terrible.
and you need a major prize.
In that case, unprecedented, single, I must live and die. I shall have to be contented with a tulip or a lily.
You will have to be contented with a tulip or a lily.
In that case, unprecedented, single, I must live and die. I shall have to be contented with a tulip or a lily. In that case, the brother will get married with a sign. Each of us will wear the other one for tea.
Wildly. part, I think, of a stage farewell to the college, to the sisters, to the students, and so on. And so there is a certain mix of feelings. But I think it was entirely appropriate that we should have had so enjoyable and so light-hearted a performance as given us tonight in this delightful Gilbert and Sullivan. It would have been unbearable, I think, to have had some heavy, sad, serious play. In fact, we've been greatly entertained, and our feelings of sadness and partings have been lifted. And I suppose it is a good lesson to us all, because in fact, no door shuts without another door opening, and no farewell but gives some sort of promise of another encounter. Just as when we say goodbye to a friend, we look forward to the next occasion when we meet. And the opportunities for doing so, we hope, lie in the future. We haven't yet decided what is to happen to the college, to the buildings, to the estate of Blairs, but recent experience of mine in another part of Scotland indicates that with one thing closing, another opportunity opens up in front of us. But as I say, my main thanks here is prompted by that thought that given the circumstances, we've had so light-hearted and so joyful an evening. And I suppose, really, with our faith and with our hope in the future, it is proper that it should be so. We would want, I'm sure, you would want me to say some particular words of thanks. The producer is Father Michael Johnston, and he has given us over a number of years some outstandingly memorable, really perfect performances. And I would invite you now to stand up to receive our accolades. Unbelieving that in fact they were what they are. not been able to give us